नमस्कार, वेलकम टू इंदिरा गांधी राष्ट्रीय मानव संग्रहालय, एन इंस्टीट्यूशन सेलिब्रेटिंग कल्चरल डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ इंडिया एंड मूविंग फॉरवर्ड इन प्रिजर्विंग एंड प्रोटेक्टिंग आवर कल्चरल हेरिटेज. ब्रेकिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कन्वेंशनल म्यूजियम एंड डिस्प्ले, इट हैज ऑलवेज बीन एट द फोरफ्रंट ऑफ कैंपेनिंग द न्यू म्यूजियम मूवमेंट इन इंडिया बाई टेकिंग द म्यूजियम टू द कम्युनिटीज एंड ब्रिंगिंग communities to the museum. Open air exhibition has been a hallmark of this museum. Among the open air exhibitions, mythological trail is unique and a new concept. The exhibition portrays the inner essence of the tribal and folk life and their world views through indigenous art forms. On the theme of tribal and folk myths, so far this is the only exhibition of its kind in the country. It is believed that a basic understanding of myth is expedient to the desire of knowing a culture. Somehow, the myths are deeply intertwined with the life and culture of the people. Today, we are again here at Mythological Trail with a new exhibit and a new story. As we know, ancestral worship is prevalent among all communities throughout India. They are worshipped for the well-being and protection from evil influences. I will share you a story of such ancestor and associated myth which is prevalent in Sindhudurg of Maharashtra, the myth of Jaitir. The myth is painted in Chitrakathi style, a traditional art form performed by Thakur community, mainly concentrated in Kudal Taluka of Sindhudurg district in Maharashtra. Chitrakathi is a tradition of storytelling by the means of painting. The most prevalent themes in Chitrakathi painting are the stories of Ramayana and Mahabharata, but he painted here the story of Jaitir. When Jaitir was very small, his sister was married and sent off to a distant village. Soon after, his parents left this world and he was brought up by a kind shepherd. Though the shepherd did not live long, by the time Jaitir was grown up enough to take the shepherd's son and set out in search of his sister. In a village called Narul, they stopped at a house for the night. They asked the woman of the house to cook for dinner the rice they were carrying. When the woman sat down to eat, tears started rolling down her eyes, and she said to herself, "The rice smells the lake water in my village." The brother recognized her long lost sister and pleaded her to accompany him home for a few days. But the sister could not recognize, as she left his brother when he was a small boy. The brother-in-law got furious with the stranger's behavior and cut off his head. The shocked shepherd ran towards his village Tudas with a shaved head in his hands. On his way, the places where his blanket and stick fell came to be called Kamlevir and Dandiyache Gadvo. Somehow, he held his breath till his village, but on reaching there, fell down dead. This is the place where a temple in the memory of Jaitir is built, and few steps before it stands the shepherd's friend's samadhi or the grave. Later, there was a temple constructed at Narul. At both places, there is a fair on the new moon of Baisakh in the month of April, May, when the temple priest dances wearing jetis masks and reads people of their misery. Thank you. We will meet soon with a new exhibit and a new story. Till then, stay safe and stay healthy.